One traditional place for local residents or visitors to spend a couple weeks summer treat is the Albright United Methodist Camp. The campground continues to be a relaxing getaway, featuring a primitive tabernacle at its center. In addition, the Albright Campground has a mess hall and numerous plots on which small cottages have been built.
This is the site of my grandmother and grandfather's lot, and they had originally had a cement slab here, and every year they pitched a big tent, big white wall tent, pitched on this lot, and during campground, camp meetings lasted for 2 weeks, and they pitched the tent here. Then as soon as camp meeting was over, they took the tent back, dried it out, rolled it up, and we hung it in the tool shed, in the top of the tool shed in our farm, so the rats and mice wouldn't get in it, and we hung it there until the next campground season.
This is a tabernacle at the camp meeting, and I actually remember going here with my grandma and Aunt Ellen. We'd come out here for camp meeting in the summer when we stayed with them, and we would come in here and they'd open up all those wooden things, so it'd be open air. We'd have chairs, benches in there. We sat there and heard the minister and sang camp songs and just enjoyed the camp meeting. It was kind of an adventure for us. And up there to my left is the big meeting where people said they couldn't eat, but we actually got to eat there one time. Usually we brought a picnic, but one time we ate in there. And it was kind of an adventure. David and I came with Grandma and Aunt Ellen, and I always remember coming to camp meeting.
Oh, Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul,
here at the childhood home of Maxine Locher, there is a remarkable resemblance between the past and the present. Although the Locher family's large garden and girls' playhouse, which once stood between the house and barns, no longer exist, the dusty road, which became especially treacherous in the wintertime, and rolling fields look much the same. The current owners still raise cattle and farm, just as the Lochers did many years ago.
I had three brothers and three sisters, and it was quite a lively, full house that we liked. This was the school where I went to school all through the eighth grade, and my home was, as you've just been to it, back this way. This way and up there on the hill. This is Jenny Joe's at my home. And we might walk, it would have been like a mile and a half down here to school.
How great thou art! How great thou art!
The house here to my right is one where my sister Joe lived with her husband Carl early. And coming up the hill to there was always a very thing that I didn't appreciate very much when all of us went to high school. My family home is just down the road here behind me, a short ways. So it was close home.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God.
We're about a half block west of the Hersey United Methodist Church, and this is the very location where the buggy sheds used to be. And there were probably, I don't know, but there were probably a dozen to 20, probably 15 to 20 buggy sheds. What there were was a shed roof, and open on the west end, and you parked the horse and buggy in there, and the horse then was under the shelter, and you parked the horse there during the services. But my father used it as a place to discipline people, And he took me one day, he was always threatening me, if I got into trouble, didn't behave in church, he would take me to the buggy shed. But he took me to the buggy shed one time, and that ended all my trips to the buggy shed.
As time passes by, let us not forget our past, but rather remember our history, all the while giving heed to the words of a former pastor of the Hersey United Methodist Church.
In a way, this celebration is not just about the past, but it's definitely about the future. The children singing and ever